It's that special time of year, and we're only a few days away from Nintendo's E3 presentation, now known as a Nintendo Direct. With Nintendo seemingly pulling out all the stops at E3 every year, I wouldn't be surprised to see some of Nintendo's biggest franchises make their debut for the Switch this upcoming year, and I thought it would be fun to go over some of the rumors surrounding those big names. First up, we'll be talking about Nintendo's golden boy, Super Mario, as we go over all the rumors regarding the Plump Plumber. So with that in mind, I'm your host, 24Kevin, here for 24KevinTendo, and these are all the Mario rumors you need to know before E3. First up, Super Mario Odyssey has always been swamped with rumors, and thanks to data mines, we know some of the things that should be coming in the future. We already know of hint art found in the game files that have yet to be used, but so far, those have already been used to find hidden mini Luigis around the home world. As it stands, we still have 12 unused hint art pieces that would hopefully be unlocked with future DLC worlds. I'm hoping Nintendo pulls a Pokken tournament and announces the DLC packs well after the game's release, and if fan demand is any indication, would sell like hotcakes. Speaking of datamine files, we also know future DLC costumes that include the Brutals, Santa Mario, 8-Bit Mario, and Zombie Mario. While all these costumes could just be timed releases, similar to what they've already done to part of the Brutals costumes, it would make sense with Christmas and Halloween coming up in a few months. But there could be more to this. Some time ago, there were rumors swirling online that Luigi's Mansion would be a future DLC level in Mario Odyssey. Of course, there hasn't been any word about this since the initial leak, but if this were true, I would assume we would hear about it at E3 or not at all. And if it is true, I'll Delfino DLC when? Speaking of Luigi's Mansion DLC, Marcus Sellers noted on Twitter some time ago that Mario Party would be coming to the Nintendo Switch in the back half of 2019 and is being developed by NCube. Unfortunately, NCube is the same company that developed Mario Party 9 and 10, aka the ones with the cars, aka the worst mechanic to be added to Mario Party ever. I for one pray they at least add in a classic mode for all the fans to enjoy, because the car ruined the board game like fun for me. Now take this with a grain of salt, as Marcus Sellers does not have the best track record when it does come to leaks, so just take that with a grain of salt and keep your eyes open for any Mario Party rumors. And finally, on the heels of Wii U games having even greater success on the Switch compared to their original run, it looks like Nintendo may not be done yet. One of the rumored ports was going to be New Super Mario Bros. U, with the Luigi U DLC included. If Nintendo did this, they would be wise to add in new challenge modes and levels, similar to what they did with Captain Toad Treasure Tracker. There was one other rumor that popped up on 4chan from user Ghost, who some of you may know spoiled the Direct for last year, and noted he was working on the booth again this year and may have revealed new Mario games in Luigi's Mansion 3, WarioWare, and a sequel to Mario Maker. Granted, the username is slightly different in this post and could be a giant troll, but otherwise, these would be huge titles to be added to the Nintendo Switch. Mario Maker has been rumored to be ported for some time, but if Nintendo wanted to add features fans were clamoring for, i.e. slopes, then Nintendo may have had to start from scratch, and I would be okay with that. And those are all the Mario rumors leading up to E3. Leave a comment down below and let me know which ones you believe or which ones you don't think are real at all. For everyone here at 24KevinTendo, I'm your host, 24Kevin. See you guys next time. Hope you had a great day. Bye!